Hey, Anna, it's your old friend Joe Hanson from It's Okay to Be Smart.
Oh, hey, Joe.
So the other day I saw this bug that had, I don't even know how many legs, but I'm pretty sure it was too many legs. How many legs is too many legs? Maybe you can help me out.
Thanks so much, Joe. What a great question. I'm gonna get to the bottom of it.
My journey to solve the mystery of the many legs took me to Dr. Paul Marrick. He's an assistant professor at Virginia Tech. He and his grad students have the super cool job of searching for millipedes, determining how different species are related, and even finding new species.
So the idea with millipedes is that they became very good burrowers with the addition of more legs. And if you think about it, if it has, you know, just four legs, you know, like a dog, it can't really burrow very well. But if it has, you know, 60 legs or 100 legs, it's really efficient at burrowing underground.
Is that because they're using their legs as little like shovels to push? So with each leg, they can push a little bit more dirt and soil away?
Instead of shovels, it's more like a bulldozer.
These burrowing millipedes use their round heads to tunnel through the earth.
And the legs are just providing traction to push this relatively smooth head beneath the ground.
The name millipede means 1,000 feet, but no species has ever been found to have quite that many legs.
The leggiest millipede in the world is a species from California. The name is Alacme plenipes. It's a really good species name. It actually means in highest fulfillment of feet. So it has 750 legs. It's first discovered in 1921, and for about 80 years, it was never found again until it was rediscovered in 2005.
By you?
By me.
Yes. Don't sell yourself short.
Paul and his brother found this elusive millipede by looking under boulders in California.
It was pretty exhilarating. I felt like I rediscovered this, you know, kind of mythical animal. So it was pretty neat.
Here's the thing though. The millipedes Paul rediscovered only have 650 to 666 legs, not 750.
So what's really interesting is that each millipede hatches from the egg with either 6 legs or 8.
What?
Yeah.
Wait, they gain more legs as they get older?
Yeah. Yep.
This is blowing my mind.
Each time a millipede molts or sheds its exoskeleton, it adds 1 or 2 additional body segments. And each segment has 4 legs. So in order to get to 750 legs, these millipedes would have had to molt a bunch of times.
So the ones with 750 legs were extremely old, you know, possibly even 10, 20 years old.
Whoa!
One of these millipedes.
That's so old!
But hey, why stop at 750 legs? Well, Paul said that millipedes have different numbers of legs depending on their habitat. Species that live on the surface have fewer legs than ones that burrow underground. And it has to do with balancing the benefits of having more legs to the energetic costs of controlling and maintaining them. That said, he doesn't think we've necessarily found the leggiest millipede out there.
So maybe, you know, maybe there's one out there with 800, 900 if it's, you know, pushing it. Maybe 1,000, you know, maybe it'll be the true millipede will be discovered one of these days.
So go outside and turn over some boulders and see if you can find the leggiest animal in the world.
During my time with Paul and his students, I learned so many amazing things about millipedes. For example, they're detritivores, which means they eat things like dead stuff and poop. They're basically nature's recyclers. But that's not all. Here are 4 of my favorite millipede facts.
Number 1, some millipedes glow in the dark. The ones you see here are glowing under a UV light, and it's still a bit unclear why they do it. But other millipedes are actually bioluminescent. They produce their own light, like fireflies, and they use that light to discourage predators from eating them. Number 2, they release poisonous gas. Unlike centipedes, which can have a venomous bite, millipedes don't bite or sting. Instead, some of them protect themselves by releasing cyanide gas. They usually only spray enough to make their attacker feel sick, but in theory, these guys could release enough cyanide to kill 18 pigeons. Number 3, Some of them smell delicious.
Oh my God, it smells like cherry cola.
But even if you blow away the cyanide, I wouldn't recommend tasting them. The smell is caused by a secretion that's another defense mechanism.
Yeah. No, it's kind of like a, it's a really spicy, long-lasting, sharp taste on the tip of your tongue.
Number four, there are lots of new millipedes left to find. Paul and his students are in the process of describing a number of new species, and that's probably because people just overlooked millipedes in the past.
Will you name it Hooray after my show?
Oh, that's pretty cool, actually.
I mean, we have enough species.
Yeah, we could be convinced.
Yeah. What?
You know what?
Hooray I.
Hooray I, yeah. If you guys come out in the field with us, come out in the field with us and we can look around and we can try to find a new species, and we can definitely name that one Hooray.
You don't have to convince me. Like, can we go now?
You can bet I'll be joining Derek, Jackson, and Paul on their next millipede collecting trip. But in the meantime, let me know if you have any questions about millipedes. Leave them in the comments or find me on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. And don't forget to subscribe so you never miss a video. Hooray! Science magic show, science magic
show, science magic show. Hooray! The origin or the location, oh, look, it pooped
Did
on
it
me.
Just poop on you?